sister, Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
As we pass through the drama of Holy Week, we're struck by the impact of this singular life, this Jesus of Nazareth, and the impact that he had on the history of our entire world. So far removed in time from the events of this day, and so magnified by our own experiences of faith, it can be easy for us to forget that while his life was truly extraordinary, while he was indeed God incarnate, the life of Jesus of Nazareth was in other ways just like any other life. He never traveled more than a few hundred miles from the place of his birth. He was deeply embedded in a local community, and he grew up embedded in a network of family members, with those who had a special closeness to him, a special claim on him as closest kin. If we take a distance from these earthy facts of Jesus' very much earthy life, it's not as though we are without a scriptural mandate for doing so. Elsewhere in the Gospels, we hear a story about Jesus' brothers and mother. They're concerned about what has come upon this family member of theirs. They're worried that Jesus might have gone a bit crazy. Jesus, it seems, could be at times something of an embarrassment to them. When report comes that Jesus' mother and brothers are looking for him, he responds with a question: "Who are my brothers and mother?" And then he responds, he answers his own question: "Those who do the will of my Father in heaven." Still at another place, Jesus says, "Whoever has left houses or brothers or sisters or father or mother or children for my sake will receive 100 times as much, and with it eternal life." It would seem, astonishingly, in a culture with such strong family ties, that Jesus is, by his teaching, loosening these ties, minimizing them in some way. But then we come to this night. And as we come to this night, when Jesus is in the midst of his most trying moment, he, even then, recognizes the women gathered to grieve for him, the women who are standing by his side. And especially he recognizes his own mother. In what is his most trying moment, his moment of trial, he sees that it's also the most trying time for this woman who raised him. This woman who treasured in her heart the meaning and mystery of his life. And he has compassion at this time. As a firstborn son, at this time and place in this culture, Jesus had certain obligations to Mary, certain obligations to this mother of his before him, obligations that clearly at this time he was no longer capable of meeting. And so he sees to her needs in the only way he can, by expanding the scope of her family. He sees his mother and John, his beloved disciple, standing alongside one another, and he declares to each, "Here is your son. Here is your mother." You see, Jesus doesn't reduce the significance of family or shrink the family. In this time or in our lives, he expands it. He grows it. He increases its boundaries until it encompasses all of humanity. And not just in this instance, but for us as well. It's Christ's death. It's Christ's cross, on which he crucifies all of the divisions and hostilities that come between us, even this day, often along familial or tribal lines. After Christ, we recognize our brothers and sisters and mothers and fathers among people who are even outside of our own tribe, even those who look, think, and act differently than we do. How greatly we need this reminder today. We need this expansion, this fulfilling of what it means to be family. How desperately we need to hear of a care and compassion that does not draw boundary lines. It's not natural to understand our family in this way. It's not easy to comprehend, and it doesn't come easy to put in practice. It was an accomplishment of the cross, to be sure. For us to love those who are not like us, who don't think like us, share our views, share our heritage, it's by its very nature a miracle that God works out into our lives and in our communities. And it's through the power of the love that Christ demonstrates on this night that that's possible. The church, the family of God, comes from every tongue, tribe, and nation. And the unity and love in this body is nothing short of a miracle. And it's made to be so. Fortunately, we are a people who believe in miracles. So this night, and always, let us expand our circle of people who, upon whom we have compassion. Let us expand the border of our family as even our Lord displayed compassion from the cross and sought family where blood did not unite. Let us be a people who love our brothers, sisters, fathers, and mothers from across all lines and chasms. Let us pray. Lord God, on this night, you demonstrated your love for us in a way that is undeniable and unfathomable. You showed that you will not let anything get in between your love for us. You love us like kin. And you invite us to see one another in that very way, in that very love. Help us to be so moved, to be so transformed, to have eyes to see our neighbor as you see them. No matter what it is that we're going through, help us to see as you saw, even in your greatest time of trial. And help us most of all to see the love that you have for us and let it move us so. This night, we celebrate your love and we stand alongside you. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Amen.